Vegas, Nevada, alive with activity 24 hours a day. And this next hour is no exception. Tonight, some of this country's best female amateur bodybuilders will compete for the overall title of the North American Championships. You'll see Kyle Campbell, the favorite in the lightweight division. And folks, she's never looked better. Texan Vicky Gates is here. What a schedule for Vicky. This is her third major competition of the year. Look for Canadian Laura Benetti to come on strong. She won the Canadian Championships overall title as a lightweight. Mary Hovey Walk has not been happy with her latest performances. She wants a title, and she wants to turn pro. Heavyweight Linda Murray doesn't know how to lose. She's won three straight overall titles, including this year's Junior Nationals. They're all here, plus more, at the North American Championships. Hi, everybody. I'm Joe Fowler, and this is the big city where there are bright lights and great entertainers, and my money out there somewhere is out there in this city. And this is my champion, Corey Everson, Ms. Olympia. Hi, Corey.
Hi, thank you.
Actually, I have an inferiority complex, Corey. I go around and people say, aren't you the guy next to Corey on the show? You're the guy. So, ladies and gentlemen, I'm the guy.
And I'm the gal.
Corey, this is a biggie here tonight.
Oh, it definitely is.
They have a chance to, well, one lady for sure has a chance to turn pro out of this.
Yes, in fact, only the overall winner gets to turn pro. And it is a biggie because there's not very many contests where you can try to turn pro.
Mm-hmm.
You have to win either the world championships or your country championships or this championship.
And we have a couple ladies from Canada, including we mentioned Laura Benetti. She won her country's championships in Canada.
Mm-hmm.
We've done other broadcasts where they've been somewhat regional. We have a lot of people from throughout the country here.
Right. This, for a lot of the girls, in fact, this is going to be a big contest because they may be used to competing in their state or a regional contest, but this is actually more like a world, actually, championships with the Canadians coming in.
The nerves tonight, huh, for these ladies?
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh.
On edge.
Well, prejudging was held earlier. We'll show you a little videotape of that. What is the format? What actually do they have to go through when they
prejudging is the very strenuous part of bodybuilding. What we see usually on TV is the presentation round, which is where your personality comes through. You pick your own music, you make up your own routine, and really your personality comes through. You try to hide your weak points, and you try to show your strong points. So if you have weak calves, you certainly don't go out there and do a calf pose. What in prejudging you also do is you do round one, which is symmetry, which is the thing that I always like to talk about, symmetry and proportion. Round two, which is muscularity, which is definition, low body fat with muscle mass. And then round three is the presentation round.
And hiding your weak points? They certainly can't do that tonight with our cameras. There's no blinking. We catch just about everything in the competition.
How would you compete hiding your weak points?
I would. I'd just put a cover over me and just say, pretend, folks, pretend. Taylor Lee is back there behind stage somewhere. She's been with us another broadcast, and she's going to give us that backstage view. She'll be talking to the competitors throughout the event. Let's go to Taylor right now. Taylor?
Thanks. The Women's North American Bodybuilding Championship certainly is a continental affair. Female athletes from the United States, Canada, and Mexico have traveled here to compete for trophies, recognition, and coveted professional status. The competition has grown rapidly in its three-year history, and it certainly has grabbed the spotlight tonight in the city that doesn't sleep, Las Vegas. I'll be backstage with the competitors, getting their personal perspective on this exciting event.
All right, Taylor, thank you very much. Oh, these ladies have suffered.
Suffered. They're in agony, mostly because they're hungry and thirsty.
They want a candy bar.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know.
Or two.
Or two or three. Well, this is their moment to shine. I mean, they're on national television. This is what they've been waiting for. They deserve their moment in the sun, and we're about to give it to them in just a moment. Just to set the record straight on the rules and regulations, this is a drug-tested event.
Yes, it absolutely is. Thank goodness it is. The women's is drug tested, although the men's is not yet, possibly next year. And it is done with an IOC, Olympic Committee drug testing procedure.
How far in advance of the competition are they tested?
Usually 3 days in advance so that they can get the results back before the final start.
So most of these ladies are here several days before the event.
Yeah, which is oftentimes very hard because you're out of your home gym, you're out of your home kitchen.
Your environment.
Yeah, it's very hard.
Okay, well, they're ready, we're ready. Right?
Let's go.
Let's do it. You stay where you are because coming up next, the North American Championships. The women are here. The lightweights are first. Stay with us. Welcome back to Las Vegas, everybody. Joe Fowler and Corey Everson. The lights of the city are on, and we are ready to begin our competition. In the lightweight division, we started off, Corey, with Mary Homier. She's 5'2", 114 pounds, 34 years old.
Excellent choice of music, too. In this contest, I'm sure we'll be hearing a lot of upbeat music, which is real popular today, and this is something totally different, which I like to see.
Now, see if you can pick on her a little bit, because she decided to enter this at the last moment, and she's saying this is the heaviest she's ever competed, so...
Well, even though she competed at the last moment, she's awfully prepared for it.
From Denver, Colorado, 7-year-old son, 6-year-old daughter, they're both rooting for her, watching her on ESPN.
I would say if she had another maybe week and a half or 2 weeks of hard dieting, it would have brought more definition into her thighs, which is always the last place definition appears, including myself, on all women.
She says that bodybuilding is a great way to get out of the house.
True.
That's unless you have a gym in your house like
yeah.
you do, huh?
Well, I still get out of the house to train.
Third place in the 1988 USA's in the lightweight division. She's been going at it for about 3 years. Training for 5, competing for 4 exactly.
Oh, that's a beautiful pose.
Nice sweep.
Really nice. It's a nice way to show the shoulder definition. That's one of the beauties of women's posing is you can go into these different types of poses. Here's more of a standard pose to show the lats, the biceps. I think if she would diet a little bit harder, train for a little bit longer, she'll really do well.
All right, she's going to head backstage, and Taylor Lee is back there to talk with her.
Mary, how long have you been bodybuilding?
About 5 years now.
And what motivated you to get into competitive bodybuilding?
I started bodybuilding after my 2 children were born.
So you have 2 children?
Yes, uh-huh.
You also were competitive in other sports as well?
Yes, gymnastics and diving. Gymnastics all the way through college.
And how did that help you with your bodybuilding?
Well, both of those sports give you a lot of muscularity, so I had a little bit of running start, even though I started bodybuilding rather late in life.
Great. Well, I'm sure your kids are proud of you.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you, Taylor. Now, already into her routine is Gail Harabian. 5 foot even, 112 pounds. She's going to jazz it up from the start. And Gail, we're proud of you. 40 years old and looking great. She's out of Los Angeles.
She's also a hairstylist. Pretty evident with her nice hairdo. You know, she's got a little bit more of an upbeat type of...
Oh!
She'll dance a little
yep.
bit.
She's got a very strong back. The rhomboids, the muscles that you see protruding in the middle of her back are very, very good. Good shoulder definition.
She's been told she's had to work on getting her legs more striated.
Yeah, I think everybody has to work on trying to get their legs more striated. Right now, the judges are looking for more of a striated, defined look in the physique. And it's very difficult for women to get to that state.
Well, she wasn't sure how to do this. Any suggestions?
Well, striations are partially genetic. Not everybody can develop striations. But a dieting over a long period of time will help that.
She held her own. Gail Harabian backstage. Taylor Lee is there, and we'll... Listen to this interview.
You look good out there. How long have you been bodybuilding?
About 7 years.
And you aren't the youngest in your class.
No, I'm 40.
Does it give you an edge, either positive or negative?
No, it's just an accomplishment.
Well, congratulations. You look good out there.
Thank you very much.
And now, already into her routine, is the youngest competitor of the evening, Paula Pyrounis. Paula is 5'3", 113 pounds. She's 20 years old. Corey, she has a string of championships, including the Team USA overall of 1988. From Rancho, California.
Well, immediately what stands out in my eyes is, first of all, her beautiful tan. But second of all, her symmetry. She's very symmetrical, and that is what is going to be able to push her eventually on into the pro ranks. It's the whole symmetry issue that we're always talking about. She does need to get a little bit more muscle mass, but come on, she's only 20 years old, and she won't hit her peak until she's probably 35 years old. It takes that long. Muscle is sort of an accumulation type thing with women. It takes a long time, but she's got very good definition, especially in her abdominal and upper body area. Legs come in last, like we said before.
I see the gymnastics background there.
Yeah, she's very confident, very comfortable on stage.
Corey, you might have been ahead of your time when you were, have often spoke about symmetry as opposed to just bulkiness. A lot of ladies and men just go for the bulkiness and sometimes forget the symmetry, but I think that these girls are catching on to that concept. Backstage with
Paula.
Taylor Lee.
The audience loved you out there. You're our youngest competitor. How old are you?
20.
And what's been your motivation to get into professional bodybuilding?
Just the hard work. I really love the hard work, and I started in gymnastics.
Who's been your biggest inspiration?
My dad. He's the one that got me started. Second to that has been my coach.
Well, I'm sure he's been very proud of you.
Yeah.
Back to you, Joe.
All right, Taylor, thank you very much. Folks, stay right where you are, because the North American Women's Championship will be right back at you after this timeout. You're looking at Las Vegas, Nevada, where there are winners and there are big losers. We have only winners here tonight. Welcome back, everybody. Joe Fowler and a definite winner, Corey Everson. Ms. Olympia, I've lost track. Probably.
Five.
Oh, I knew that. I just want to hear her say it five times. And you have a little history with this competition.
You know, I actually forgot about it. I had won the North American Championship way back in 1982 when it was not a pro qualifier.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, it was not. But, man, the level of competition is by far greater now.
Mm. Well, we've just seen the lightweight. And just to clue you in, folks, the lightweight can win overall. I know Laura Benetti from Canada
right.
won in the lightweight division and won the overall in Canada. So you're seeing lightweights, but this is not by any means meaning they're lightweights in their abilities. They can win overall.
Absolutely. It doesn't happen real frequently, but it can happen.
Okay, the audience here in the auditorium is ready to continue. Who is our next competitor, Corey?
Tracy Kulubiak's up. And she's already into her routine with a very interesting starting point.
Just came out of the cocoon.
Yeah, she also just came out and showed that she's got excellent symmetry. Tiny little waist, broad shoulders. Very good definition on all of her body, equally defined. She doesn't have any glaring weak points that I can see.
You like her the best?
So far, yes.
So far.
Absolutely. She's still a little bit lean, but that will come with more years of training.
5'3", 113 pounds. She's 30 years old from Peoria.
She's also a bartender and a personal trainer. And
met her husband, Brad, at the gym. Sound familiar?
One thing I really like about her is that she likes to diet over a long period of time, dropping only a pound a week. And that way you can avoid losing muscle if you diet very slowly.
Slowly and consistently.
Mm-hmm, that's very smart.
She's a winner, won the Gateway Open, first place in the middleweight division, and won the overall. In 88, she was second place in the lightweight of the USA. So she vacillates from lightweight to middleweight, depending on the competition.
I think the way she looks, I think she can eventually be a middleweight. Lightweight, remember, is under 114 pounds. She's 113 pounds, but she's still very lean. She does have excellent symmetry.
All right, Tracy Kulubiak is finished, but we're not done with her. We're going backstage, where Taylor Lee is there. She'll talk with Tracy.
Tracy, talk to us about genetics. How important do you think it is in bodybuilding?
Oh, I think it's really important to have basically big shoulders, flaring thighs, which I don't know if I really have yet, but I'm working on it.
Who's been your biggest inspiration in bodybuilding?
I really don't have like an idol or anything, but my husband has been really helpful to me over the years. I couldn't have gotten through this without him. He's the one who helps with my diet and helps keep me pepped up and has to put up with me and my moods, which aren't always the most pleasant.
Well, you did well tonight. Thanks a lot.
Well, there's one lady who was judged number one in the lightweight, and we are now going to watch her.
Don't need your advice.
Listen to this open.
What I need, you can't give me.
Ooh, excuse me?
Hot stuff.
Gotta have the real thing.
Okay. This is Kyle Campbell. We had to stop and take a listen there. Kyle's 5'3". She's happy. 108 pounds, 27 years old, and she knows she's hot. She knows she did well in prejudging.
She's totally prepared. What we were saying before, she doesn't have any glaring weak points. She has those striations in the thighs that all these women are talking about trying to get.
Well, her friends call her shredded wheat.
I can see why. I can definitely see why.
This lady's involved in documentaries, produces documentaries, scientific documentaries, such as medicinal plants. That's one of her favorite topics. She says it helps her for nutritional knowledge.
Oh, definitely. I can see that with all the herbal plants and that type of thing. Remember, this is a natural contest. It is drug tested. I can see why she's called Shredded Wheat. When she poses her triceps, she's got crustaceans in her triceps, too. And that's very hard to get. She probably diets over a long period of time, too, because she has maintained a certain amount of muscle mass along with definition.
She has really worked on it, Corey, and she's made great strides because in 88, at the Women's National, she was fourth place in the lightweight. She's really, really worked on her routine and her body. Kyle Campbell leads the stage. Let's listen to her with Taylor Lee.
Kyle, the audience loves you. You are not a novice to competition.
No, no. I've been in Nationals and first North American, but I love it.
And also competitive surfing.
Yeah, competitive surfing and competitive swimmer. I just love it, yeah.
Well, you were wonderful out there. Congratulations.
Thanks a lot. How's it doing? How about playing number one?
All right, number one. And she is Joe Fowler and Corey Everson. We will be right back with you. The middleweights are next. Stay with us. Beautiful shot of Las Vegas, Nevada. We are down in that city somewhere, Corey, and we're a part of the entertainment capital of the world, and we are definitely being entertained tonight. We're in the middleweight divisions now of the North American Women's Championships, and you are looking at Melody Bennett, 5'4 and a half, 123 pounds, 30-year-old from Southfield, Michigan.
Do you think any of these girls are doing any gambling while they're here?
I'd say just being here is a gamble for these girls. Yeah, they've spent some time down on the table. Although this is an amateur event. They're not paid.
That's true.
They don't have the money to gamble.
Right.
Right.
She's got some beautiful poses in there.
Good movement. Melody wants us to make sure that everyone knows she is a natural. Has been and always will be.
Well, everybody in this contest is a natural. They passed the test.
You know, you were commenting on her movement and the posing. She's choreographed other bodybuilders' routines.
I can see why.
That's a strength.
It's really hard. A lot of people don't have rhythm. And sometimes it's hard if she has rhythm to teach somebody else rhythm. That's very difficult to do.
Boy, Melody's on a roll. She won the Powerhouse Classic in 87 overall. Overall at the Highland Competition, the Southern Michigan Competition, the Tally Hall Classic. She's won overalls in four competitions.
Wow, that's excellent. She also is a hairstylist and fashion designer. She designs earrings. She works with leather, women's clothing.
She's with the big girls now, though, this North American. She was prejudged fifth, so.
Well, she looks really good. I think she needs to get a little bit more hardness, long-term dieting, a little bit more heavy weight training. Maybe a rep between 8 and 12 to get a little bit more beef on her body.
Well, at 30, she's been bodybuilding for 3 years. That's cute. She didn't pick it up until she was 27 years old. Let's go backstage.
Melody.
Taylor Lee is waiting to talk to Melody.
You look a little nervous out there. Great, but a little nervous. Do you get nervous when you're competing?
Yes, I do, but I'm overcoming it.
What goes through your mind when you're up there?
Oh, I don't know. I guess it's just getting used to being out of state.
And what do you do when you're not bodybuilding?
I'm a fashion designer.
Good deal. Great job.
Already into her routine now. Let's watch Rita Hatch. Akron, Ohio's Rita Hatch. 5'4", 123 pounds, 34 years old. An aerobics instructor.
And a total difference in music and style posing. She's doing more classical type poses versus Melody that was jiving on stage.
I have a feeling it's going to start to move.
I think so. She does work as an aerobics instructor, so I predict she'll have some faster beat music in here.
She has a 12-year-old daughter and a 10-year-old son watching her.
Beautiful pose. She has wonderful development in her torso. When she does a front-on shot, you can see the serratus, the muscles on the sides of the stomach, and also the muscles directly down the front, the erector.
Rita's also competed in the heavyweight division at 123. She is in the middleweight now. but she won the overall at the Niagara Falls Pro-Am Grand Prix in 89, earlier in the year. She also teamed up with Dave Durth, who has since turned pro. They were in the mixed pairs national champion in 88.
Great abdominals. Excellent.
Very nice.
Beautiful.
Rita Hatch.
Rita. A little out of breath there. You had said that when you bodybuild, you saw quick gains right away. What did you attribute that to?
Gymnastics, track, cheerleading, all that. Just an athletic background.
Yeah. You did well out there. How's it feel?
Feels pretty good. I'm a little tired and dry.
Do you get nervous competing?
Once I'm on stage, I'm pretty good, but it's being back here that's the killer.
You did well tonight.
Rita was just a tad tired. They finished their competition, go right back in Taylor Lee grass.
Oh, that's so hard. I know it is. You're totally out of breath.
Kimberly Hughes is next. She's from Canada, one of two Canadians competing tonight. 5'4 and a half, 119 pounds, 26 years old. And this, folks, is her first competition outside of Canada. Welcome to the USA.
So far, every Canadian I've ever seen has got blonde hair.
Is it natural?
I don't know.
They must have this thing about wanting to be blonde. Must be they see posters of Corey Everson. I don't know.
She's a critical care nurse. She's been a nurse for 2 years.
Concentrating on the back here.
She's adorable. A lot of women start bodybuilding because they're not happy the way she looks. She was happy the way she looked before she got started.
Good for her.
She has her own style of posing, too.
Interested in triathlon. What an athlete.
Kim, you look good out there. You've been competing in other sports.
Yes, I competed in the national swimming competition as well about 4 years ago.
How did you make the transition to bodybuilding?
I was in university. I have my honors degree in phys ed, and that's when I started training. I was actually dating a football player at the time.
Good job. The date worked, huh?
Yes, yes.
We have the top two middleweights and all of the heavyweights coming up next from Las Vegas. Stay with us as the North American Championships continue. Las Vegas, Nevada, this is our second broadcast from this exciting city. Earlier in the year, you hopefully saw us with the men. Now we've got the very popular ladies' competition at the North American Championships. You're looking at Vicky Gates. She's on the stage and into her routine, 5'4", 119 pounds, 27 years old, from Dallas, Texas. She's a trackster, Corey, ran track at Oklahoma State University. They've got a fine program.
Yay, for those tracksters.
That's right, you little trackster. Yeah.
She's been bodybuilding for 5 years already. Beautiful shoulders, beautiful arms.
She's married, and if you're married, your spouse better be involved in it, too. That seems to be the case, and
well,
her husband is a bodybuilder.
Yeah, he's also a patrolman. I think he arrested me once for speeding.
Oh, watch it. Don't say that. What do you like about it?
Oh, her upper body, excellent, good definition. It's very deceiving. She looks sort of real round and smooth until she poses, and then she gets hard and nails and ripped. Her legs need a little bit more, which will come in time. She's got great shape.
She's had a busy schedule in 1989, competing in the Gulf State Championships and the Junior USA.
Beautiful pose.
That's the way to end your routine. Hey, do you want to meet a champion from Canada? Laura Benetti's her name. Here's her profile.
I used to be a runner, and then I was put on a weight training program. I found myself enjoying the weight training much more than my running. My body reacted really, really well to the weight training, and in my first year I did so well, and I love the competition, that I finally found the sport that I enjoy the most, and I hope to do really well in it. During my off-season, I train 6 days a week. Prior to a contest, it means training 7 days a week. That means waking up at 4:30 every morning, going to the gym, cycling for an hour, going to work, working from 9 to 5, and then finally going back to the gym for my weight training. Once I get home, I've got one little bit of training left to do, and that's running my stairs. That's my apartment, up and down 5 times. I love it. Being a Canadian and competing in the United States, I find that there are several similarities and differences. First of all, I wish that there were more Canadians involved in the sport, more girls getting involved and getting into shape. Secondly, I find that the Americans are much more competitive in the sport, but hey, that's okay. My goal in bodybuilding is to turn professional, compete in the Ms. International, and hopefully to compete in the Ms. Olympia. But I'll still keep my amateur status for as long as it takes and hopefully encourage other Canadians to work out, get the dedication and the strength to keep the sport going.
Now let's watch Laura Vannetti on stage. We know a little more about her. She's 5'4", 117 and a half pounds. From Toronto, 24 years old. She's been training for 5 years and competing for 4.
She used to be a competitive long-distance runner, and you never really put long-distance running in with bodybuilding. But you know what? Look at her calves. There's proof of long-distance running. That soleus muscle underneath the calf, the gastrocnemius, is huge, and that's from distance running.
And that's so hard to develop.
Oh, it is.
Speak from experience what? Boy, this girl has done so well. When you think about the fact that she won the Canadian Championship, first place in the lightweight, and overall as a lightweight.
That's hard to do. Yeah. Her body really defines what being ripped is.
She doesn't train her arms, she said. How does she get away with that?
Just genetics, I guess.
Oh, some people have it.
Maybe when she runs her long distance, she's got dumbbells in her arms. I don't know. She's really got good arms.
She's won almost every contest she's ever entered.
Unbelievable definition in her thighs. It's really hard to get that definition because you end up sacrificing a little bit of size in order to get the definition out. Nice poser, too.
Very good. Laura Vannetti, champion from Canada, going to try to do it here in the U.S. We'll have the heavyweights at the North American Women's Championship next. Welcome back to the North American Championship. This city can be awfully cruel to people. It's been very nice. We've enjoyed it. The ladies here, it's been tough for them. I can't say it's been a cakewalk. They really have a grueling competition on their hands, and it's not over. Prowling out onto the stage from the heavyweight division, Deb Tyler. She makes her entrance known.
Very stunning bikini, too.
Deb is 5'5", 138 pounds, 35 years old, from Fort Lauderdale, Florida. There's no paint on her body, huh?
No, probably not. She's an x-ray technician. She works for an orthopedic surgeon. Nice leg.
Former cheerleader. Says this is the best she's ever looked. To be in the top 5 in this show. Well, she was prejudged at number 5, so she accomplished that goal.
Yeah, I think that she needs maybe one more week of heavy dieting. It's so hard to look at yourself in the mirror, and it's all relative. You look in the mirror and you look great. But when there's other people that are more ripped than you on stage, then you don't look as great. And your head really plays games with you when it comes down to 2 weeks before a contest. Am I in shape? Am I not? Am I too lean? Am I not? Am I ripped enough? Am I not? Boy, I hear it from me all the time.
Well, she's a small fish in a big pond now. You know, this girl, for 8 consecutive, rather 7 years now, she has placed in the Florida State shows.
Mm-hmm.
But this isn't Florida, folks.
No, this is big time.
Yeah. Been married for 12 years, so you know she's got a fan watching.
Yeah. This is really a good contest for women to enter because it is a pro qualifier, and there aren't many pro qualifying contests.
Consider what she's been through, folks. Not just the prejudging earlier, but the months and months of dieting, and in many cases, the years.
Years of training,
yeah.
Years of eating properly.
Deb Tyler, very nice. She'll head backstage. Taylor Lee is there. Let's
Deb,
listen.
This way. Boy, you couldn't tell by the routine that you've competed nationals, but not poorly.
Yeah, that was many years ago, though.
Also, you put on a little weight since those days.
Yeah, I used to be like 112 pounds, so I started lifting weights.
How long did it take you to gain from 112 to, what are you now?
148, I weighed in. About 6 years.
You've done well.
Thank you.
All right, already into her routine is Mary Hovey Walk. Corey, haven't we seen her earlier this year?
Yeah, she competes frequently.
Yeah, that name is very familiar. She's 5'5", 135 pounds, 31 years old, from Phoenix, Arizona.
Great deltoid. I've always loved her physique.
All-around athlete, tennis,
you know,
golf, racquetball.
Right, and she looks so darn healthy, and she's just like, you know, Little Miss All-American girl, blonde hair, and she just looks healthy. Doesn't have that blonde face look that some of the athletes get.
Didn't you know that dental hygienists are all Little Miss Americans?
Oh, yes.
She is one. Bodybuilder for 9 years.
And she's always been known for having beautiful thighs. Nice sweep to her legs.
Well, last year her legs overpowered the rest of her, which can be a problem. It can be a drawback.
Little waist, nice big lap. She's very comfortable on stage. I can't imagine her being nervous at all, the way she's moving.
Mary Hovey Walk completes her routine. Let's check in with Taylor Lee as she has a discussion with Mary.
Mary, for a woman who says she's stage shy, you sure went for broke out there.
I know, that was fun. I worked with a good choreographer for that.
How does it feel when you're up there and you know you got a solid routine?
It feels great. It feels really wonderful.
Does it help you get over that stage shyness a little bit?
Yeah. I always get real tight at pre-judging, but then the night, so I know it's over and it's off the fun, so it's just go for broke.
Well, you went for broke. You did well.
Yeah, thank you.
All right, we have a few more heavyweights to go, including Joni Bovino, 5'3", 133 pounds, 32 years old, from Mar Vista, California. Personal trainer who worked out at Gold's Gym in Venice. Pretty good credentials right there.
Yes, she was just recently on our TV show, too, Women of the 21st Century.
The lady's ahead of her time, huh?
Absolutely. Last time I saw her compete, she won the 1989 L.A. Bodybuilding Championships, which is a very hard title to win.
Before that, she won the Iron Maiden competition. She's throwing some dance into her routine.
Mm-hmm. She's an excellent choreographer, Lainey Singer. I think Joni's a little bit smooth, though, in this contest. She does have the muscle. She's got the mass. Her definition is a little bit off. She is normally known as being totally, totally ripped to the bone.
I see what you're speaking of, the smoothness in the abdominal area and the shoulders. She was prejudged number three, third in the prejudging earlier today.
Says that she had a little bit of personal problems getting ready for the contest, but she did a very good job getting ready for it, that's for sure.
Well, she was trying to go into this competition a little heavier.
Which I think is really a mistake. A lot of men and women both try to do that. Go in heavier, to be bigger, to be more majestic on stage, but usually the person who's most defined will win out.
Joni Bovino handles the applause from the crowd. Now she'll go backstage and handle Taylor Lee.
Joni, you compete quite a bit. What kind of condition do you feel that you were in for this competition?
Not my best. I try to. I'm a little heavier than usual, and it didn't quite work out. But it's been great fun.
The audience loves you out there.
Hey.
You did well.
It's a fun routine. I really enjoyed doing this routine. It's a little different than I usually do.
And how's that?
It's a little dancy. But it's a fun, silky fun. You know, they want to tell people that you can work hard for you. It's fun and feminine.
You did well.
Thank you.
We have got a treat for you folks, because coming up next, the top two in the heavyweight division. Stay where you are. We welcome you back to Las Vegas, Nevada, in the North American Women's Championship. Joe Fowler and Corey Everson joining you again for what many people believe is the best part of the competition. You have, what, two left in the heavyweight competition. Two of the best, too.
Yeah.
Including Liz Karp, who we'll see in just a moment.
And we have seen Liz for the last probably 7 or 8 years competing, and she's always been great.
And after her is Linda Murray, who we saw recently, too, and you talk about great.
And she's on a roll, that Linda Murray, she really is.
You identify very closely with the heavyweights, I'm sure.
Yes.
I mean,
I'm a super heavyweight.
You're a super heavyweight.
Yes, I am.
Okay, were you always in that category?
I mean, yeah, I was always a heavyweight, because really, heavyweight is 125 pounds and over.
I couldn't see you under 125 pounds.
No, I'd be anorexic, I think, if I were, but really, 125 pounds is not that heavy for somebody who's 5'8".
Have you been impressed with what you've seen so far?
I certainly have.
All right, we're about to see Liz Karp right now, but first, before she hits the stage, let's meet her up close and personal.
I got involved in the sport of bodybuilding because even as a child, I was pretty muscular, and topped that off with a couple years of track, a couple years of gymnastics, a few years of dance, and I was really already pretty much set on the muscularity level when I started. That was 6 years ago. When I started off, I was competing nationally. I still am, but I think I've made a great deal of improvement. I've really learned a lot every year, and I'm still learning a lot of new techniques, new things out on the market to compete as a natural athlete. When I started, I was competing as a middleweight. Now I'm competing as a heavyweight. I've had to change my whole perspective on contest preparation. Instead of thinking small, over dieting, over training to make weight, I have to think big, stay up there with the big girls. When it comes to training, my main concern now is attaining mass. One of the things I found that's helped me do that is incorporating basic heavy movements and low reps into my training routine, even through those last grueling workouts that are so hard to get through. Let me tell you, it's made a huge difference in my physique. If they hadn't instituted drug testing in women's bodybuilding, I probably wouldn't be competing right now. On the other hand, they're starting to change the judging criteria. They're looking for the whole package, someone who's intelligent, attractive, poised, and very muscular. Hey, wait a minute. That's me.
All right, we have met Liz Karp one-on-one. Now let's watch her work on the stage. Santa Barbara. Liz is 5'5", 136 pounds, 31 years old. 7 years as a bodybuilder.
And she is ahead of her time. When I first saw her compete 7 years ago, I thought she was ahead of her time.
And she continued to set a pace?
Yeah, but what's happening is the other girls are starting to catch up. I mean, she was naturally muscular and athletic, and now these other girls that weren't training normally are now into training and catching up.
I think you bodybuilders are your own worst critics. I know that Liz says that she needs more symmetry, and why they're lax, you'll be the first to admit it. Can you go along with that?
Well, I think she's got really good lats. I think the strong points are her muscle mass along with definition. She's a real good look. She's cute as heck. One thing I really love about her is she's an animal fanatic. She's trained horses and cares for them. She's got a great skin tone, great tan.
She doesn't have a pig, though.
I do. She really has got nice legs, too.
Going into this competition, she felt she was at her peak. That's all you can ask. If you feel like you have arrived and you're at your peak, it's the best time to compete. She's
always
at number two, though.
Uh-huh. And she's always been a very, very fine poser.
Liz Karp completes her routine, a little wave to this audience in Las Vegas, and they are ready for number one. So are we. Who is it? It's Linda Murray, and wow, we've seen her before,
yes,
too.
Yes, we have.
I think I'll just hush up and watch.
Yeah.
You can talk. She's great.
She is, and she's just got the most tremendous size, too. She's weak in the calf, and that's her own admission, too.
but she's great. 5'5", 140 pounds, 27 years old.
140 pounds, that's a big girl.
She has won 3 in a row. Miss Michigan overall, Great Lakes Open overall, Junior Nationals overall. She's going for her 4th.
She's also a cheerleader, so you may see some of the
Nice.
You may see some of the moves she has from cheerleading. Total control over all of her muscles, bellies. Excellent control.
We broadcast the Junior Nationals that she won.
Mm-hmm. I think she's a little bit smoother in this contest.
Wait a minute, just answer the phone. Hold on.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
Oh, it's for me.
Who's that for?
Oh, it was a nasty call. Good for you. You hung up on that guy. I hate those phony phone calls when you're on my routine.
I don't have the problem. I'm sorry.
But I think she is a little bit smoother than she was in the Junior Nationals when she won that. But she certainly does have the muscle.
She's been bodybuilding and competing for 6 years.
And she's got a lot more years left in her head, sir.
Well, she's 27. We see her going into the 40s.
I can see her entering the pros shortly.
We're going to see her in the pose down, folks. Prejudge number 1. I'm psyched for that.
I love watching her pose. She's very innovative.
Nice. Linda Murray, she leaves the stage quickly, but we're going to have her and 2 other champs back up on that stage. The pose down in comparison coming up next. The North American Women's Championships are coming to an end, but this is what you've been waiting for, folks. The pose down. Let's go back inside. 3 champions. We have someone from Florida, someone from Canada, someone from Michigan. Got them from all over. On the far left, in the lightweight, Kyle Campbell. The middleweight in the middle is Laura Benetti. And, of course, Linda Murray, you just saw, she's the heavyweight. Now they'll break up and decompose, of course.
Now let's compare bodies. We compare them within their own weight class. Now we've got 3 different weight classes on stage.
Reminder that Laura Benetti, who's now on the far left,
mm-hmm.
won an overall as a lightweight.
Right.
She's competing as a middleweight, so she's very capable of taking this trophy.
Right, now what we're looking at the difference between total width, threaded loose type look, that we were talking about before, and muscle mass and muscle size. And Linda Murray is the one with the muscle mass, and Laura Benetti is the one who's threaded. So, it's going to be a decision that the judges are going to have to make, what they're looking for. Who seems to have a little bit of everything?
That's Laura Benetti from Toronto. And there's Linda Murray.
Yeah.
I think I know
who I'd choose.
Well, let's go. Who are you going to choose?
I would have to say Laura in the middle because she combines everything, muscle mass along with the definition.
Let's listen in.
The people
on the new show, Mr. Neil Babbitt
and Mary
Thomas,
give them a
hand and
a great job.
We're
applauding
some of the staff
that have put together. A little PR work here. And the girls are going, come on, I want to know.
We have Kyle Campbell on the left, Laura in the middle, who Corey does like for the championship here. I'm a front runner, I'll go to heavyweight.
And bring it out too. Contestant number 42.
42 is Linda Murray.
Linda won it?
Linda won it.
I never get them right.
You're not supposed to. You just judge them on your own. Beautiful though. Linda, you know, they're all terrific. Linda won it. Hey,
yeah,
she's on a roll. Junior Nationals and now the
now
the North America. She does have that opportunity to come pro now.
She only had a confusion. She doesn't sell as now. She's pro already. She's so lucky.
That's terrific. That's Linda Murray, arms up. She's a champion. And I'll be back with my personal champion, Corey Everson. And we'll have the interview with Linda. Questions, closing comments. Stay with us. Welcome back to Vegas, everybody. Joe Fowler and Corey Ederson. And it's a good thing we don't depend on your predictions week in and week out.
I'm so bad. No, and I've been on the worst.
Where do you see the best in all three?
I know it.
But Linda Murray did win it. And in fact, Linda's backstage. We'll have an interview with her in just a moment. Taylor Lee is working on that. Why did she win? What were her best?
Her best thing, she does have a lot more muscle mass than the other girls. The other girls have mastered the definition, whereas Linda has got the muscle mass. But she also has very, very good symmetry. And I think that that's probably it, too.
Now, having won this championship, can she just automatically go after, say, your title?
Actually, not this year. What she has to do is she has to qualify for the Miss Olympia. The Miss Olympia is the main contest, the most difficult contest, actually, for the women's pro circuit.
Mm-hmm.
So what she needs to do is she needs to enter either a world championship pro or the Miss International and get in the top five and then she'll qualify for the Miss Olympia for next year.
So there's still more steps.
More steps.
All right, Linda Murray is backstage and Taylor Lee is there too, so let's go to the interview with our champion.
Tell me about the thrill of victory.
Oh my God, this is amazing.
Well, what does this mean to you? Tell me what it means.
Oh, it means everything to me. It's the world. I've trained so hard for 6 years for this, and I'm so pleased. I'm very pleased. I'm excited and tough competition.
Yeah. So are the diets and the training over now, or what are you going to be doing right now?
Well, I'll continue to have two guest poses to do, so I'll stay in good shape. And I know now that I have to stay in good shape and be ready. I don't want to can't go into that syndrome of overweight and, you know, I'll freeze in.
Well, a very, very big congratulations. You're marvelous, and you totally deserve it.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
All right, Taylor, thank you very much. So, now, if Linda Murray could huddle up with Corey Ederson, what would Corey Ederson tell her? What kind of advice at this point?
Oh, at this point, I think she needs a break. She's competed in actually four shows now. And I think
won all four of them,
and she deserves a break. She needs to get out of the gym a little bit, maybe just run or swim or do some kind of fitness activity, but just get out of the gym for a while and relax. And then decide which contest you want to enter in and plan out your attack for that one.
Okay, well, we're out of time. We've got a couple more shows here. What's our next one?
Men's Nationals.
Men's Nationals is coming up. Stay tuned for that. For Corey Ederson, Ms. Olympia, Taylor Lee as well, I'm Joe Fowler. Thanks for watching. Good night, everybody.
Good night.